Are humpback whales really vigilante sea beasts that guard the world from killer whales? A pod of killer whales in Antarctica has a seal cornered on an ice floe. Just as they knock it off and close in for the kill, a humpback whale bursts upward beneath them. It uses its flippers to hold the seal on its upturned belly, keeping it out of the water until the predators leave. We all love it when someone stands up to a bully, and there are records of humpbacks saving all kinds of animals from killer whales, including sea lions, sunfish, seals, and gray whales. But are they doing this intentionally? Are humpbacks the superheroes of the sea? The marine ecologist who saw the humpback seal scenario I just described is Robert Pittman. His team has published a new study in the Journal of Marine Mammal Science that takes a closer look at what's going on here. An adult humpback is so enormous that it's pretty much invulnerable to a group of killer whales, and when it gets in the middle of a brawl, it uses its massive pectoral flippers to basically say, "Ah, hell no, step back, son." They slap the water and bellow, pushing the killer whales back. This mobbing behavior is a response we also see in birds, insects, fish, and other mammals to chase off potential predators. Humpbacks have foiled killer whales everywhere from Antarctica to the North Pacific. Sometimes they even work in pairs and will travel over 2 kilometers to ruin a killer whale hunt. They've been observed to keep fighting for up to 7 hours until the prey can escape. The team's research looked at 115 documented interactions between humpbacks and killer whales from 1951 to 2012, and they found that almost exclusively they went after mammal-eating killer whales instead of those that just eat fish. We're talking more like the 1977 horror movie Orca than we are Free Willy here. And while humpbacks do mob killer whales attacking their own calves, 89% of the time, they're saving other species entirely. So why are humpbacks doing this? They're not known to mingle with these other species in any other circumstance. Pittman's team thinks the humpbacks are drawn to the scene by the sounds killer whales make during their attack. And there's 3 possible motivations driving this behavior. 1, a proactive warning to killer whales not to mess with their kin. 2, altruism. Or 3, pure revenge. Since killer whales do attack young humpbacks, it's possible the adults respond to all attacks with extreme prejudice. But humpbacks are capable of sophisticated thinking and communication, so it's also plausible that they display a regard for other species. Dolphins do, and so do we, sometimes. But what if it's simply humpback reciprocity for past killer whale attacks on their family? Remember that shark in Jaws 4, The Revenge? It's like that, except for instead of chasing Michael Caine, they're after killer whales. Or maybe we shouldn't try to interpret their behavior through human experience at all. There's more research to be done, and even Pittman contends that this behavior may unintentionally arise out of self-interest we just don't understand yet. I, for one, look forward to the day I can ride a humpback named Mermax into battle. But why do you think humpbacks are thrown down with killer whales? Let us know, and to keep up with vigilantes, marine life, and more, be sure to check out now.howstuffworks.com every day.